मनु भाकर, हिंदुस्तान में नाम पिछले दो दिनों से हर किसी की जुबान पर है। क्या बच्चे क्या बूढ़े, पूरा देश आज मनु भाकर की उपलब्धि पर गर्व कर रहा है। आज एक बार फिर मनु भाकर ने देश को जश्न मनाने का मौका दिया है। दो दिन पहले निशानेबाजी में ब्रॉन्ज मेडल जीतने वाली मनु भाकर ने आज 10 मीटर एयर पिस्टल मिक्स्ड इवेंट में निशानेबाज सरबजोत सिंह के साथ एक बार फिर ब्रॉन्ज मेडल जीत लिया है। मनु भाकर और सरबजोत की जोड़ी ने साउथ कोरियन एथलीट को हराकर यह मुकाबला अपने नाम किया है। दोनों ने 16-10 से इस मैच को फतेह किया, यानी भारत ने अब तक ओलंपिक में दो मेडल जीते हैं तो दूसरा मेडल मनु और सरबजोत की जोड़ी ने जीता है। इसके साथ ही मनु भाकर एक ही ओलंपिक में दो मेडल जीतने वाली पहली खिलाड़ी बन गई। हरियाणा के झज्जर में जन्मी मनु भाकर ने स्कूल के दिनों में टेनिस, स्केटिंग और मुक्केबाजी मुकाबलों में हिस्सा लिया। मनु ने 14 साल की उम्र में ही शूटिंग में अपना करियर बनाने का फैसला किया था। उस वक्त रियो ओलंपिक 2016 खत्म हुआ था। इसके एक हफ्ते के अंदर ही उन्होंने अपने पिता से शूटिंग पिस्टल लाने को कहा। मनु बताती हैं कि उनके पिता रामकिशन भाकर ने उन्हें बहुत सपोर्ट किया है और उनका हमेशा साथ दिया और उन्हें एक बंदूक खरीद कर भी दी थी। वो एक फैसला था जिसने आज मनु को ओलंपियन बना दिया है। मनु ने अपनी पहली जीत के बाद एक इंटरव्यू में ये भी बताया था कि कैसे उन्होंने इस समय भगवत गीता के श्लोक को याद किया और उसी रास्ते पर चल पड़ी।
You also know the history, right? You are the first Indian women shooter.
Yes, by now many people have told me.
So that is also history you have created. So a lot of history you have created. How does it being part of so many history and what it has done is that a lot of medals, people were saying shooting medals not coming somewhere or the other. You have kicked the door. You have opened the floodgates. Now I think medals starts flowing.
Well, I'm hoping that, and we definitely look at the positive side. So it's not like we shooting cannot give medals and all. It's just you have to put in faith. Okay, one time it was not good, or twice it was not good, but you always have to be positive. That's the least you can do, and then you can just leave everything on God. Just have faith in God.
Talking about the last one that you spoke to the PM, mm-hmm. Did that conversation happen? What was the feeling?
I mean, before coming to the Olympic Games also, we had this session with him, very motivational and all. I felt really good at that he took out time in his like this busy schedule also, he made time for us. And even after the medal, we had a long conversation. And he congratulated me, and it means a lot to me. Like him taking out time in his like so many things he has to do, but yeah,
and
feels good.
Did you the Olympic bronze medalist? Has it actually sunk in now? You're an Olympic medalist.
Yes, it has sunk in now because I have a match to shoot tomorrow. But the feeling is surreal. I feel so good. I feel really happy that I could win this medal for all of us, and this is coming home after so long, so many years it's been for shooting in the like winning a medal, podium finish and all. So I'm so happy that it's coming home with me, and maybe many more will come in the following days, maybe in shooting or other sports, but many more
can actually happen if Manu can get us two more. It's all right, it can be a better color as well.
Yeah, I can try. I will definitely try my best, but you never know like what the outcome shall be. So
but you know, in the very second day of the Olympics, India has won a medal. So the start, you have given the India the right kick start and the boost to all the other athletes across sports, including shooting,
mm-hmm.
to pack a punch and, you know...
Yeah, I realize that. It probably gives confidence. Even if I have heard about somebody like winning a medal on day one, I would be energized too. I would be also confident, okay, I need to like, you know, push myself. I need to try my best, give my best efforts. So I'm grateful that I could do it for anyone who feels that way. But